Some of these options have been cut due to high costs. And as we see in this next clip, the Onondaga County Legislative Chairman finds out that there is no financial plan for this project.
What I wish happens is that in the draft environmental impact statement, a tunnel is studied, and hopefully one of the ones that maybe will work, because some of the ones that came out very early seemed like they were engineered not to work. I would also ask the question and just point out the fact that this is a federally funded project. Congressman Katko was very successful over a year ago in working with his colleagues to obtain $300 billion in a highway bill that is continually funded over the next 6 years. That's money each year. So there's money there, right? There's money in our state delegation. I saw the governor this week touting infrastructure projects throughout downstate New York. This is upstate New York's infrastructure project. So what I hope happens out of this is that we study a tunnel in the DEIS, because if we don't, we aren't being honest with the community. We just aren't. And then going forward, we see what the cost is for that project. We ask for what the budget is. What's the budgetary number? I've never seen a capital project of this magnitude be taken off the table for cost when you can't even tell us what the budget for the project is. Is the budget $2 million? Because then we can look at our options. Is it $3 million? We can look at our options. So it's incredible to me that the policymakers who are over here, the people in charge of the budget for the state of New York, which hasn't even been done yet, we have an incoming president talking about a $1 trillion infrastructure bill, all these opportunities to get money to fund a project that will bring this community together, and we're not even gonna study it. It's incredible. It really is incredible. So I would ask just this one question. What is the budget for the I-81 replacement project?
I'm not going to dance around this. We are required as part of the decision-making process to put together a financial feasibility study to fund the construction. As it stands today, that has not been done, and that is a process that is parallel with that record of decision we talked about. The differences between the costs associated with the viaduct replacement or the community grid or the tunnel are very different. You would put together different financial feasibility studies.
So after this, you jumped in reminding him about the Tappan Zee Bridge and no financial plan there.
No,
and it's being built.
There's still none. It's going along quite well. And I asked in budget hearings of the governor's people year after year, what's the financial plan? Well, and then you get the dancing around, and there is none. So if it's the right thing to do, and by the way, the people that are trying to get this compromise, we're not spendthrifts, just wasting money. I'm probably one of the most conservative people in the Senate. But this is a 70-year project. Mm-hmm. If it costs some more money, if it's a reasonable amount, and it takes care of all of the concerns of the people out in the Finger Lakes, town of Salina, and the traffic flow for truckers coming from here, everywhere. It's an interstate highway. It should be maintained as that. So we're going to try to do it as best we can, but to get no numbers and then say it's just too costly, which they have up to this point for the compromise, he admitted it. There's no numbers. There's no financial plan. So how does he know that this is too costly? So that's the frustrations, and you hear it in my voice because you hear the stuff over and over, and you start wondering whether you've lost your mind because it doesn't make any sense.